witnesses to. This is additional to the matter, to the first petition that we treated. There was nothing like that.
Now, you are supposed to be the
decoy.
The decoy, that is. I don't know how you put it in military terms, but they were supposed to assassinate you. That was the plan.
That's what, yes, correct.
To trigger out, yes, to
correct.
Trigger out this.
In fact, when you hear the audio cassette, then you will know who was so vehement on how my assassination should be seen to be what should spring the execution of the coup.
And that led to your confinement in Azorok. You're not to go out at all.
Correct.
For how long did you stay indoors?
I still move about till, I think, the 13th, the 4th, either 14 or 15 of December, that is when Colonel Garba came and met me. On yet another decision, the petitioner took, in the absence of General Bamaiyi.
Major, Major.
In the absence of General Bamaiyi.
Major, please. On the 12th we've spoken about.
Yes.
On the 13th we've spoken about.
Yes.
The coup that was supposed to take place fully on the 12th was to be triggered off by your own assassination.
No,
right?
On the 12th. It's good to get me right. It's good to get me right. Every other day, the coup was slated for was called D-Day. When it fails, it now becomes an ablated or a failed D-Day. Then they fix another one. That was what they were doing. So that was why it was very critical. Every single meeting was brought forward. Once they bring it to the late CNC, I will listen to it, transcribe it, tell the surveillance team of SSS, and they continue.
Do you know Major Al-Khali?
Very well, my lord.
Are you aware of the fact that the former chief of general staff said he brought the coup speech to him? Are you aware of that?
Very well, my lord. And even when Major Al-Khali was arrested, was first brought to my office. He didn't know nothing. Let me explain. His boss, he was ADC to Major General Olarewaju. Major General Olarewaju gave him the coup speech in two envelopes. The first one inside was waxed and sealed. The outer one the same. And then it was personalized to the petitioner. He brought the envelope the way it is without knowing the contents or why he was then sent to Abuja. Poor young officer. He brought it, okay. And he was picked.
Nigeria na fine country, oh.
Ayayando.
Everything we go make them better, but.
Ayayando. One people, one future, let's stay together.
Ibrahim Sabo had in his evidence in chief before the commission said General Bamaiyi told him after General Abacha's death that Chief Abiola chose to be killed to balance.
General, do you remember the 22nd of April 1990?
Yes, I think I do.
You do? In relation to?
Hawker School, I think.
Hawker School. You played a role during the Hawker School that brought you into limelight.
Well, I'm not sure about that, but I know I played a role.
No, you led the loyal officers to the government.
I did.
To repair the coupes.
Yes, I did.
You thereafter became the GOC.
Not exactly.
No, you became the GOC Lagos Garrison.
After commanding the Brigade of Guard Staff.
I will want to bring you back to your response, which you read out in the box here. In your response, you did talk of the fact that the Chief of Army Staff Conference took place at Enugu on the 8th.
Yes, I did.
You did. He equally said that you had some series of meetings with the former chief of general staff in respect of the, you know, the planned coup.
Yes, I did.
And in mentioning those dates, you talked of the 11th.
Can you please return to the page?
Yes. Page 5, paragraph G, I suppose.
Yes.
Yes, if you look at that place, you will see the date. We met again in the CGS office on 11 December 1997.
Yes.
You go to I, you see that you met again on the 13th of December 1997. And that the largest meeting of all took place on the 14th of December 1997. Am I right?
You are right.
In your earlier testimony, as regards the bomb blast of the 13th of December 1997, you said you flew into Abuja on that 13th of December 1997.
No, I said flew in on Friday the 12th of December.
Yes. You got to hear about the bomb blast on the 13th.
Yes, when it's
on NGA.
In the evening, yes.
In the evening, yes. The meeting you held on the 13th of December 1997, at what time did it take place?
That was in the evening in General Adia's house.
With General Adia was present?
Not on the north of the 13th.
On what day?
General Adia was there on the 14th.
On the 14th?
Yes.
You want the commission to believe that a person who miraculously survived a bomb blast on the 13th will be available mentally alert to hold a meeting on the 14th, planning a coup?
Well, that's exactly what happened, and other members who are at that meeting are still around.
Yes.
He was there on the 14th and he chaired that meeting.
You remember the evidence of Major Al-Mustapha that there was a planned coup on the 12th December 1997?
Yes.
Were you aware of that coup plan, or it is the same plan?
It is the same plan when the head of state is supposed to have traveled out, if I'm right.
No. The head of state went out.
That's for the Jumat prayer.
For the Jumat prayer.
Yes, it's the same. It's the same plan.
Now, five of you, let me put it that way, were the principal people, officers drafted into this coup plot. That is to say yourself, Adisa Olaniwaju, whom you got to know later on.
No,
forget the word drafting. I mean, people who sat together to have these meetings, and we are aware of this plan. Yes. Now, amongst all of you, including the then CGS, it's a stupid question, forgive me. Who was the most senior officer at that time?
The CGS.
When a coup is being planned in the army, please educate us if you are wrong.
Well, I'm not an expert.
No. I didn't say that. Okay. When a coup is being planned, the person who finances that coup and is the most senior officer available if and when that coup becomes successful, does it become automatic that person will become the head of state?
It is automatic.
It is automatic.
We go by hierarchy and seniority.
The hierarchy, good. If it is automatic, why then was the then CGS reminding you that, boys, don't forget the hierarchy?
Well, just to he wanted to make the point that anyone maybe wanted to do something else will be dealt with.
No, no, no. Don't forget the hierarchy. You mentioned it three times.
That's what I've said.
Very good.
He was reminding
you
that he was senior.
Yes.
And of course, that is what he wanted. And we had no objection.
And you think it is normal that he should remind you, apart from you knowing the fact that he's senior,
well,
apart from the fact that he put down $50,000 and thereafter came up with 2 million naira as the financier of the coup, you think it was necessary to be reminded about that?
Well, in this case, this is somebody who told you that he was not in the... He's not with the government, he was not recognized and the rest of it. So there was nothing wrong with him reminding anybody.
Thank you. You went around many units as the chief of army staff, pleading with officers to subject themselves to civil authority. Am I right?
Yes, I did.
You were equally involved in setting up coalition committee to discuss about what they think about the likely succession plan of the former head of state.
You mean the military initiative?
Initiative, yes. In the course of your evidence yesterday, you did say that you thought the entire people of Nigeria, or citizens of Nigeria, were fed up with the late CNC's government.
No, with the military and governor.
Yes, that is the late CNC's government, isn't it?
Well, it is the late
CNC. No, that is it.
Well, they were fed up with military government.
Thank you very much. And that they should make... Yes, they were fed up with the government. Does that not tell you that that government in itself merited being moved away?
Well, no matter what sort of government you have, when you talk of change of government, if it is by force, it is illegal.
Illegal, thank you. Thank you very much. It is illegal if it is by force. Now, you as the chief of army staff, you went to meet the then head of state to tell him about the planning of the coup,
which was reported to me by my subordinate officer.
Yeah, by General Caesar. Yes. And he said, if you carry on, you know, with the meeting as scheduled. Yeah?
He said
you should play along. Yeah? My position now is, with the playing along, and unfortunately, after or in the process of the plane along, you met Dia and others. Was the GOC, one mechanized division, ever co-opted by way of getting troops available?
I've told you that no GOC was co-opted.
No, you promised that it will not be a problem to get the GOC.
That is part of the plane along.
Thank you.
But I did not contact any GOC.
Any GOC. If you look at page 12 of your statement, paragraph E, now, I can remind you what is there.
Just asking you, sir.
Okay. That there was a sort of accusation within the group that you wanted to become the head of state, and what there would be the position of the lieutenant general, the chief of general staff.
That is not even. He is talking of troops. If I go to that page,
well, come to that statement. What exhibit? Exhibit.
Oh, sorry, sir. Exhibit 14. Sir.
14 or 24? Yes.
24. 24, sorry, sir. Sorry, the paragraph C. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Yeah. You were saying this by way of your defense as to why, you know, it could not have been possible for you to become the head of state or for you to nurse it at all. That if the coup had been successful, the former chief of general staff was then your senior anyway. What position would he then occupy if you had become the head of state?
That's true.
Have you not seen situations where coups are successful and younger officers take over power?
Well,
from 1966 to 1997.
As I've told you, I've never planned one.
No. Now, I'm not saying
yes,
that.
I have not seen that situation unless you put me through. Okay. If those situations arose, let me just finish. It means the junior officers must have planned it and took over. You don't say Jacob for anybody to give him power.
Now, I was trying to give you the example of the 1966 coup. And if you remember the 1966 coup, General Aderonsi came in. He was removed. General Gawan came in. As at the time General Gawan came in, he was not the most senior officer in the military. Remember?
You might be right, but who actually planned? You are talking of the counter coup now.
Yeah.
How do you know that General Gawan was not part of it? He was the chief of army staff.
Yeah.
So who else do you want that was senior to take over? I remember, yes, there was a senior officer who was contacted and rejected it. And you cannot force somebody to take leadership. That's my answer.
Can we make progress, please? Sergeant Vidal was what?
But that was to protect my point, my lord. No, as regards the first one.
But he planned the coup. He planned the change of government.
Now, you said to the best of your knowledge that it was out of complete selfishness that the former chief of general staff and his hatred for the former head of state, that was the reason why he was planning that coup.
I say so.
And it was not in the national interest.
I don't think so.
Yes. And you equally said that it was better in the course of discussions that a clean break should be made from the army if you want another head of state.
Well, that was a different situation. That was after the coup. I did say
yes, it's true.
Yes, I said so.
With what we were told yesterday about your whispers to General Sabo, would it have been possible, or would you not have thought that the clean break, instead of a retired general becoming president, would have been Bashir Abdullah who got the mandate as a clean break from the military?
Well, thank you for that question, because they brought up something yesterday, and I will pledge your indulgence to allow me. Now, in the first instance, when you talk of Chief M. Abiola, I have told this Honorable Commission in 1995 the efforts we made with some people to get him released, which of course I think somebody here clarified that.
I think you better answer the question first before elaborating. The question is, if you really wanted a clean break, was Abiola not the best choice, the best option?
It was reasonable, but I was not in a position to implement that.
When you are saying clean break, you have to work with the politicians, I suppose.
What my clean break, my lord, what I meant is to have a non-military person, not a serving or retired officer.
I see.
That's what I meant, to have a civilian.
Yeah, General. Do you know Lieutenant Colonel M. Garba?
Yes, I do.
Did the Lieutenant Colonel have troops under his command?
Yes, he was commanding officer, 3-Guard Battalion, Abuja.
Abuja. Did you recruit him or get him into this group so as to make things easy in spite of playing along?
General Zia directed us to recruit him. I did not talk to him personally, but I got an officer to talk to him.
Was he getting him?
Yes, of course. That's why I was at all most of the meetings.
Now, aside from being professional colleagues, that is yourself, sir, and General Aziza, is there any other relationship between both of you?
We only met ourselves in the army. So our relationship is more professional.
My lord, not for that question.
To show who you truly are, your true self.
Well, I hope you really know me.
Will you please realize that here, when I ask you questions, your duty is to answer the questions, and the answers are meant for my lord and the commissioner, not for me. So don't try to think you're going to be rude or clever. Simple questions, simple answers.
My lord, I think we are starting on the wrong foot. It is wrong for you to start thinking of rudeness. Please, I respect you. You respect me. You will help this commission.
What I told you, I was advising you, your answers are meant for them, so don't be rude in your answer. That's what I'm saying. Let us go to business.
That's better.
Now, General Abamaiyi, you had only a grade 2 teacher certificate. Am I not right?
I have a master's in military art and science. I have a master's degree.
In what?
So you are wrong. In military art and science.
Look, you are not following my question. When you joined the army, you only entered with the 2 certificates.
Fine,
that's
yes. Yes.
That's all right. Thereafter, you went on an emergency course during the war for 3 months. Yes or no?
Not 3 months, let me just add.
Yes
four,
or no?
4 months. Just four to correct
months.
You, yes.
4 months. And thereafter, you are commissioned into the army.
Yes.
Very lucky.
I thank God.
You set up this 1997 coup trial.
Coup trial?
The trial.
The trial I did not.
Who arranged for the chairman and the members of the panel?
The chief of defense staff.
Chief of defense staff?
Yes, please.
And you had no hand in it?
At all.
You had General Madu yesterday when I asked the question. Is it right? Or is it the practice? Is it the regulation that when you want to have that type of court martial, the person deciding and the member must not be below the rank of the accused?
Not
I want to ask you.
You did. And he answered you correctly that it was not
necessary.
That's not necessary. Are you familiar with the law or regulations governing the army?
I think I should.
You should. I want to prove to you that what he said and what you are confirming is wrong.
Well, if you can explain that.
Where an officer is to be tried, the president shall be above or of the same or equivalent rank and seniority of the accused, and the members thereof shall be of the same but not below the rank and seniority of the accused.
I've heard that. But
you remember also.
May I just
wait a minute, just answer the question.
What I can remember, I need for clarification.
Just me, let
you yourself say the convening officer, where the appropriate rank is not available. You read it, I did not read it.
Look, that was for a different section. I just read the whole to you. Now, let me say, you remember, some time ago, I don't know whether you're in the army or not, in a place, I think the place is not very far from the Commonwealth country, Barbados, Tumago and Barbados, they had a trial, a ministry trial in that country. They had nobody senior enough to try the accused persons, and Nigeria was approached, and it was Nigeria who supplied the president of the court martial. Do you know?
I do, but it is not because they are.
Do you know?
Of course I do.
What is the name of the man?
General
Tiwa Danjuma. You're right.
But then
now. Wait, look, my question is to ask questions.
And my duty is to answer.
Now just answer my questions.
But I have to explain.
Of all Commonwealth countries, the practice borrowed when we were British subjects up to now, according to our law, is that what you did in the case of the 1997 coup was nothing but a kangaroo court.
You are wrong.
Do you agree or you don't agree?
I don't agree. You are wrong.
Right.
And let me.
I don't want any lecture from you, please.
You can't tell me yes or no answer.
I don't want
any. We are in a commission.
Well, Mr.
I have to explain. Otherwise,
Alagi,
I'll be quiet.
Alagi.
I'm not Alagi.
Please listen. Just let me ask you a question.
I'm not Alagi. Let me explain this.
I don't want an explanation.
What you have to ask?
Just answer a question.
I can't answer a question.
I think you're helping us. If you want to explain, what's wrong with it?
Well, Milord, I have in mind, my lord, if there is any need for explanation, your lordship would agree with me, the counsel who brought me would examine.
I know.
That is the law.
This is not a court of law.
And your lordship has indicated.
Hold on.
Your lordship has indicated.
This is a court of law. Witnesses in the out of court and out of hearing. But nobody bothers about it. If it's a court of law, most of these cases will not be admitted. So that's the difference. And if somebody wants to explain, maybe to help us. I don't see anything wrong with that.
Lord, I have been told before that there is a time limit within which I can cross-examine this witness. If I allow the major part of my time for him to be making explanations, then I would not be able to make any headway.
I will extend the time.
Yes, sir.
Well, counsel,
let me
not think it wise to reserve this point. It's a matter of law. Yes.
Well, that is true. Well, you say he knows it. That's why I don't want to ridicule him. Very well, sir. I will go forward.
No, let me answer that. Before you go forward, I have not answered that question.
I think the witness is hold his peace.
No, my lord, I agree. But you see, there's a difference
because it's a matter of law.
You are not a lawyer.
No, I'm not, but we are talking military law, and there's something that is not correct here. He is talking of a decree, and these people are tried by tribunal. They are two different things. It is necessary.
Thank you very much.
That's what my lord.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
That's all right.
Now, General Bamaiyi, is it normal? In other words, is it correct for a junior officer in the army to be above a senior officer and giving orders? Is it right?
For a junior officer to give orders to a superior officer?
Yes.
It is not right.
It's not right. Thank you very much. Now, in the Nigerian Army, number one is the commander-in-chief, that is the late Abacha.
Correct.
Number two, General Diya.
Correct.
Number three, General Abdul Salam.
Correct.
You are number four.
Well, the service chief.
Yes, you are number four.
The service chief.
Yes, all right. Now, if you are talking of service chiefs, of all the service chiefs, the service chief of the army is senior to Navy, Air Force, and others.
Just on protocol, yes.
Yeah?
But sometimes they are senior in...
It's all right, okay. So I don't think there's any point you are making. I know what I'm saying. Now, that is the order.
Yes.
If you succeed in a coup to kill Abacha when he was alive, to kill Diya and like General Abdul Razam, then automatically you're going to be head of state.
But there was nothing like that. There was there was no full plan like that.
I'm putting it to you. I don't know where I'm going.
Well, I wanted to learn quickly.
What I'm putting to you is that you wanted a coup to make you head of state.
Diya wanted a coup to be head of state. That is the truth.
Do you know about the four-point plan, four-point demand?
I heard about them in this commission.
You never heard of it before?
Never.
I think that you are not a witness of truth.
Well, you have your right to say anything, but I did not know anything about four-point demand. And no officers mentioned about them, I can confirm.
Also today, Brigadier General Ehoza Oviawe was before the commission. His complaint was that former Chief of Army Staff, Lieutenant General Ishaya Abamaiyi, influenced his compulsory retirement from the army. His offense, he said, was a suspicion that he was a member of the pirate confraternity.
General Oviawe, when in your petition, you said when, after the retirement of Colonel Menka, Colonel Monde took over.
Yes,
and he came to you and told you that you were free to go and that you have been retired.
Yes,
and he sympathized with you.
Yes, my
well,
lord.
Why would an officer of the security group, of the DMI, who was part of the system that was detaining you, sympathize with you?
Yes,
why did you
lord.
Think he sympathized with you?
Yes, my lord. This is one of the reasons why I am insisting that the report that from the basis of my retirement should be assessed, because the gentleman took over a unit. He had officers who would have briefed him on the happening. He would have been briefed on the situation of every detainee. And I am convinced, my lord, that he had found out that there was absolutely no need.
Did he really sympathize with you? What exactly were the words he used to show that he was in sympathy with you?
Yes, he told me and said, Oga, I am sorry this has happened to you. It ought not to have happened to you. But please take it as an act of God. I know you are a good Christian. God must have had a plan in allowing people to do what they did.
Those are his exact words.
Okay. Now, in paragraph 5 of your petition, you said, finally, on the 24th of July, when Monday, you know, the point here I want to draw attention to is, though I knew that the action was against normal procedure, the action of, what action exactly are you referring to?
The action of taking my identity card from me before I was given a letter of retirement. Ideally, the letter of retirement, or normally, the letter of retirement will be accompanied with a form requiring you to complete and return the identity card. I wasn't given no such form until the 5th of August, 1997, 1998.
So that's the abnormality or irregularity you refer to.
Yes.
Right. You also said that you eventually got a letter in which you were told to surrender addresses, dresses number 1, 2, 3, uniforms 1, 2, 3.
Yes,
my lord. Would you like to explain exactly what uniforms 1, 2, 3 mean in the army?
Uniform 1, my lord, is the ceremonial dress. Uniform 2 is the service dress. Uniform 3 is the mess kit. These three dresses are normally given to a retiring officer so that on occasions that a national is invited, he comes out in them. And normally too, when an officer is being buried, and is being buried militarily, he normally is dressed in ceremonial dress. That is the pride of an officer, and this was taken from me.
Yes. So this is why you felt that you were discriminated against, right?
Yes, think? My lord.
Okay. Can I have the exhibit? My lord, I would like to have the exhibit. Well, as a matter of fact, the point is already very well before the court. What is the commission? Exhibit 3, the letter of retirement, shows in paragraph 5 that the officer should be depicted less than ceremonial mess and
service
dress. But the signal sent subsequently denied in the the exhibit four. That's
five.
Would you summarize to the commission your position, which you canvassed in your letter to the DMI, the security group, in summary?
Well, my lord, I, in that letter, I think that the point made throughout that letter was that I am not a member of any court. In fact, my lord, I do not belong to any civilian organization. And that the only reason I was at the marriage of Onoche was that the man was a very, very kind person to me. At the time, especially during the first custody, this gentleman dumped 3,000 liters of fuel in my house because of the humiliation my driver suffered at the military petrol dump. He was there when they denied the driver petrol. And when we met by accident, and he was describing the situation, and I now owned up that it was actually my car. He now said, an officer of yours should not suffer such humiliation. So he gave me 3,000 liters of fuel, which I again now sold to fellow officers who were suffering from not having fuel. Because of that, I was endeared to him. And I promised him, I was also teasing him, he was a bachelor at about 35. I told him he was too old to be a bachelor. And he promised that any day he was going to get married, he would make sure that I was chairman of the occasion. So when he decided to take a wife, he called me, he wrote me a letter, and I gladly accepted to be. And that was why I was at that ceremony. It is true that at that ceremony, some people came to say they were pirates. And that was when I knew that gentleman was a pirate at the time.
That's okay. General Viawe?
Yes.
I was asking which court uses the hammer. I don't know if the American or the English court. What do you think? The presiding justice does this.
Thank you, my lord. Is it usual for officers to request for change of telephone numbers, which apparently you did, and was that request was approved by the your annexee, which is exhibit six.
Well, my lord, it is not the normal thing to do. But like I said, my wife was being harassed, my family was being harassed by anonymous telephone calls, threatening them with death. And when she came, I requested and the approval was given. In actual fact, my lord, these are part of the harassment resulting from my detention. If I was there, my family would not have been subjected to such harassment.
Okay, General. Would you like to explain to the Distinguished Commission what you meant by the news, that's the news of your detention, devastated, like you said, my family, especially my wife, who has been hypertensive. Did you mean your wife has been hypertensive, or that your wife has become hypertensive as a result?
Yes, as a result of that situation, she has become hypertensive, and she is still on drug up to today.
My lord, I think that will be all.
Thank you very much.
General, sir, I would sincerely want to sympathize with your family if what you said about children is actually correct. Now, you stated that you were invited to the DMI. General Bamaiyi did not arrest you to take you to DMI. Am I correct?
You are absolutely correct.
Very well, sir. Now, at the DMI, the allegation against you was that you were a member of a court. Am I correct?
You are right.
Very well, sir. You joined ABU in 1972.
No.
No. When did you join ABU, sir?
I actually joined ABU in 1967.
67?
Yeah.
Now, it was by way of an admission letter given to you that you were admitted as a student of ABU Zaria. Am I correct?
Absolutely.
In that admission letter, you were not admitted also as a member of the Pirates. Am I correct?
I was not a member of the Pirates.
No.
I wasn't.
Yes. It was after joining the school that you also now got admitted into the organization or association called Pirate Confraternity.
You are right.
Yes. I will also be correct to say that the duration of your stay as a student in ABU Zaria was indicated in your letter of admission. Am I correct?
You are correct.
Yes. You left Zaria in 1972. Your association membership of Pirate Confraternity terminated with your leaving the school.
Yes, my lord, because it is a student organization, or it was a student organization. Yes. I don't know what it is now.
All right. In 1975, you got married.
Yes, my lord.
They were there at your marriage.
Yes, my lord.
They added color to your ceremony.
Yes, my lord.
The pirates or who?
Pirates. The next time you got in touch with them was at the marriage of Ononche.
I actually
No.
My lord, you asked a question. I will want to answer. The marriage they attended in 1975, I did not invite them. That is a statement of fact. So in Ononche's marriage, I did not
know them. It is true, they came not as we used to be. They were dressed like any normal person, any ordinary person in suit. And they came and said they came as members of the pirate confraternity to award him a sword to protect his wife as a symbol of protection. That happened. I didn't know them from Adam. I don't. Today, if I see them, I will not even recognize them. That was how it happened.
Yes, sir. I don't have any problem with that at all. What I am saying is that, of course, you did not invite the ones that came for your wedding.
No.
I am asking you, they added color to your wedding.
Of course, yes, because they were beautifully dressed.
Thank you very much, sir. At the Olonche's wedding, people came and introduced themselves as pirates.
Yes.
The allegation was that Mr. Onoche was the head of the pirate confraternity in Enugu.
Yes, that's what I was told at the security group.
Take a look at exhibits 1 and 2. Did you anywhere deny knowledge? Did you anywhere in exhibits 1 and 2 deny knowledge that Onoche is a member of, or is a leader of the confraternity, pirate confraternity in Enugu? Just anywhere.
I didn't.
I want to give you some time, please. Wait. Don't rush. Just take time.
Time is against us, so he said, don't rush.
If there's anywhere I did, let me know, because the pages are many.
Okay. I put it to you that you did not deny knowledge that Ononche was the Oga Patapata of the Pirate Confraternity in Enugu in both exhibits 1 and 2. You did not. I'm putting it to you.
Please let me understand that question. I did not deny knowledge.
Are you aware of the allegation that Ononche was the Oga Patapata of Pirate Confraternity in Enugu?
In actual fact, I told you before that at
are you aware of group, those allegations?
At security group, I was told that he is the boss of Pirate Confraternity. Yes, I was told.
So you are aware of that allegation.
Now,
that,
yes.
No, at the DMI.
At the DMI, yes.
Yes. You made a statement at the DMI.
Yes.
Did you deny knowledge that you,
yes,
Brigadier General, know that you did not know? They told you at the DMI. Did you say I didn't know?
That no, I did not deny it.
Thank you. Yes. You did not deny knowledge that Ononche was the Oga of the Pirate Confraternity.
Because I was not asked.
Thank you. Now, you enjoyed tremendous benefits from your relationship with Ononche, including the crude oil research you got?
I got petrol from Ononche.
Okay,
yes.
Refined crude oil.
He didn't give it to me as a gift. I paid for it. But he supplied it because it was not readily available in the market.
Sorry, so it was
a favor he did.
Was that the only favor you ever got? It's sincere. You have said you are a good Christian. Was that the only favor you ever got from him?
The other one was when my uncle, the Yasser of Dini, died. I and General Semuta went to him, and he helped us to get I think it was 10,000 liters.
10,000 yes. liters of oil.
Now, but we paid for it.
Okay. Now, since they came at that wedding, did they also add color to Ononche's wedding like they did in your wedding?
No, the three people came. They were all dressed in normal, civic dress.
They did not add color?
None whatsoever.
They didn't add color.
No, not that I saw.
Okay. Now,
haven't you made the point? First of all, your client did not arrest him, not detain him, not torture him.
Yes.
Now, a question about court.
And my client did not.
Circumstantial evidence.
I'm sorry, sir. My client also did not add color to his wedding ceremony.
No. Yeah. Is your client one of the cultists?
He didn't say it for him.
What? I don't know what else you are digging for, because everything is already...
Okay, my lord. Thank you very much, sir.
Nigeria, a fine country.